Social network analysis is basically the study of how people are connected to each other. What we study is the set of relations among a set of entities. It could be an organization, it could be a country, it could be a school. And what we do is we map them and then construct metrics to try to characterize, like, what is the structure of that network? And try to figure out, why does it have the structure that it does? We also look at the individual and see, so where is that individual located in that structure? It's hard to find something that is not organized as a network. If you're trying to understand something about the world around you, you kind of have to learn something about networks. They sort of act like pipes, and through a network, things can flow from person to person, particularly in organizations, which is what I study. It's how things get done. It's how work gets done. It's how we coordinate, you know, the 370,000 people that work for IBM. How do they all work together to get something done? It's through formal and informal networks. I mostly study centrality, which is the concept of the advantage that accrues to a node by virtue of its position in the network. So some nodes are more central, and there are certain advantages to that. So for example, one way in which you could be central is that you're not far from everybody else in the network. There are few steps in between. People like that tend to hear things faster. So if information is flowing through the network, they hear it early, when they can take advantage of it. One of the things that central people have is that they're connected to lots of different pots, different parts of the network. And this part over here is talking about certain things, and this part's talking about certain things. And the person that happens to be connected to both can realize that the problem that they've got has already been solved by that group, and they can really provide a lot of value. The big data issue. Normally, particularly me, my work is done with surveys. I take 500 people and I do a survey, I ask them a bunch of questions, and it's all voluntary. They provide the information if they want to. But you can't do really large groups with that. If you wanted to study the structure of the network of IBM, we'd want to use some other means, like maybe look at the emails traffic that goes from person to person within the organization. Or maybe we go to Twitter or something like that. We're not actually talking to each person and getting each person's permission to do that. So now we've got some privacy issues, and that's going to be the case increasingly as we use Facebook data, Twitter data, and so on. We've got to resolve that. And it may not be a legal issue, but I think it is an ethical issue. Also an issue of getting people to participate. If people think that their data are being used and we're not somehow paying them for that kind of data or in some way helping them out with it, there's no reason for them to do it. About a decade ago, the chair of my department, Dan Brass, made a strategic decision that we were going to be excellent. And we were going to be excellent in social networks and management. And when she started to bring some really good minds, developed this really great concentration, and that's why I came. I was at Boston College, and I came here because I couldn't resist the idea of a management department that was focused on social networks. And it's been a fantastic decision because the moment I came here, my productivity went up. The College of Public Health has a lot of network people. I've seen new hires now in communication and education. Throughout the campus, there's a lot of interest. Having that many people together makes it possible to do things that you just can't do otherwise. We created the Link Center for Social Network Analysis. And one of the things that the Link Center does is that we put on a workshop every year to teach people how to do social network analysis. We have trained now over 1,000 people, and we do that with a staff of 28 instructors and assistants. And the only way to field that many people is to have this huge concentration here and have all of our graduate students doing the same thing and all of our faculty. So it is an ideal place to do what I'm doing.